Hello, assalamualaikum guys, and welcome back for more Gintama Rumble. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget, thank you all for the I appreciate all of the likes, subscribes, all that. FYI, my place is raining, so you guys can expect to hear some raining. I guess Team Malaysia is in now in raining season, or at least at my place. I don't know about other places. Could be. I think that's also. Let's get this game on. So I think I'm gonna continue the gameplay for Baragaki side story. And let's get this.
土方さんが見回り組を引きつけてる間に俺と近藤さんで鉄の助を救出するね。なんだ総合、作戦に異論でもあるのか。まあちょっとお前らしくないな。遠慮せずに行ってみろ。この作戦だと土方さんがいい感じに目立ってムカつくんでさ。そんな理由。 そもそもなんでバラガキ編、六角事件編にしろ、バンナムこの野郎。どうせビルも上位獅子も使い回せるんだから、とっとと作りやがれ。それに新選組の人気を考えたら、動乱編もあって叱るべきでしょうよ。企画書には書いてあったの。ただ作ってみたら思ったより戦えるステージになくてだな。言い訳は聞きたくねえ。責任取ってもらうぜ、
バンナムさんよ。そうだな。まずは俺の攻撃力をデスタワンパンで倒せるまで上げよう。バカなこと言ってないで、鉄を助けに行くぞ。Hey, hey. Sorry guys for going silent. I'm then gonna cut that silence. So this is Okita Sogo, okay? So in the hierarchy in Shinsengumi, or at least the rank, the characters, so the chief of Shinsengumi, you can say he was the one who, let's say he's the captain of all of the Shinsengumi. So that is Kondo Isao, and the vice chief is Jigata Toshiro, the one we played in the Baragaki arc. And for Okita Sogo, he is the captain for the first squad, and there's a branch of other squads. There's second, third, and so on. So Okita Sogo is the captain of the first squad. You know, another funny thing about Okita is that he always tries to kill Hojikata Toshiro, even though they are in the same police force, Shinsengumi, because the reason why he wanted to kill Hojikata Toshiro because he wants to become the vice chief. That's right here. So this is like he's fighting for the position. Achievements, at least 80%. 200 combos defeat. Oh, in my notebook, eh? Let me rumble. All right. Okay. All right. Oh yeah. Also, and also about Okita Sogo, if you watch back the cutscene, so they mention about two arc. First is the Rokkaku arc. So in the Rokkaku arc, it was mostly self-centered on Okita Sogo. So you can say like this is an arc for where Sogo got his spotlight, something like that. or his character development, something like that. Another thing, and but it's a kind of serious arc, but you can say it has nothing to do with the plot. Another arc that was mentioned is Shinsengumi in Crisis arc. So that arc, I think it happens between Binizakura arc and Yoshiwara in Flames arc. It was between them. I think it was like episode 100 plus, something like that. So it was between those two arcs. So it's a really serious arc, but seeing that it wasn't chosen to be in this game, so I think it's like it doesn't have anything to do with the plot, even though it is serious arc. So to me, I don't see it's less that it has anything to do with the plot, but I can understand why it will have. I can understand if people said that it will have to do some. It has something to do with the plot. So I think. But anyway, let's get this.
Sonja, ikimasu. Kono tatakai, sugu ni owarimasu.
Wait, they didn't. When they supposed to explain how Okita Sogo's, what do you call that? Gameplay is supposed to be. I have to say, I really like his playstyle, right? Rather than Jigata Toshiro. This is the one I was saying, the explanation. A lightning fast EI sword master, his sparring movements translate to huge combo damage without having to get close to enemies. On the other hand, this technique heavy character demands good judgment and situational awareness due to low defense and limited attack range. Alright. Oh my god. Damn, I really like his playstyle. Rather than Hijikata Toshiro, because it's fast. It's really fast. Hijikata Toshiro's game playstyle is kinda slow. Come on, 19 more. So, character that. A personality trait of Togo is he's a sadist. He's very sadistic. So another character that was really sadistic will be, you know, a lot of character in Gintama has a, they have a very sadistic. We call that sadistic personality. There's a lot of character in Gintama where the character was a very sadistic character. even though the most famous one will be Gintoki and Kon Togo, but I tell you guys, there's a lot of characters in Zama is really sadistic. I can say unintentionally or without them, it's like happens naturally, something like that. Oops, this guy is too fast.
Yappari, anata mo keisatsu janai. Watashi to onoshi, hito goroshi no ne.
Zaki, Kondo-san no koto tanoma.
So, masaka omae?
Kondo-san, koitsu no nerai wa bonkura no kubi demo. Mashite teki no kubi demo ne. Ore no kubi de sa.
Iie. Anata no.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Dokiagare. Mushi desu ka e? You want me? Come on, come here. Oops. Oh yeah. Dude, I need some health. Ooh. Oh my god. Oh man, she just got break me. Get out of my face. Yeah, so as I said earlier, Togo is a very sadistic character. So sadistic is something like where this guy just really like, this guy's really like to what do you call that? Sadistic person will be something like where a person really likes to torture somebody, and you know, something like, you can say something like, this guy's really like blood, really like to see blood. Like, you know, a lot of people when they see blood, they will get disgusted, but a sadistic person would say something like, if they see a blood, they won't really feel anything, or they would even indulge it. Like, they really like it a lot. At least that's how I see, because of the characters in Gintama. That's how they behave. What's more about sadistic, eh? Okay, so again, it's not really too, it's not, it doesn't really just happen in a torture scene. Woo! Yes, God. Oh, but it doesn't really happen in a torture scene. So I think even when you fight your enemies, you can just be a sadistic. You know, it's like you can say something like, these guys are very are getting really extreme when it comes to fighting. Like, when they were fighting, they would really choose to like kill them very horribly, something like that. Something like that. Where let's say if you fight somebody and you kill them, you didn't just cut him, you didn't just slice him or stab him. You would go far more than that. It's like you will cut the person in slices, and then something like that. You cut the person into slices, into parts, into slices of his body. You know, there's the hand, there's the finger, something like that. At least, again, this is how I see how the... At least that's how I see the sadistic person. Wait. If man's if cleared at least. Okay, so as I said earlier, that Gintoki and also Togo is a sadistic, as a sadistic personality. So in some of the first episodes, Gintoki. In the, you know, in the early episodes, when they were, when Shinsengumi was introduced, I don't know how it really went, but at some point in time, Sogo called Gintoki as Danna. So, when he called Gintoki, he would call him as a Danna. So, that was in Japan. So, the translation is like something like boss. So, Sogo regards Gintoki as a he really respects Gintoki. To the point he calls him as Danna or boss. Oh my god. What the heck is she doing? Hey, let me run away. You can't kill me yet, okay? What the heck is she doing? Somebody blended me. What the heck? I got you. I said at least when Togo called Gintoki as Danna or boss. So as I said, he has high respect towards Gintoki. Anyway, you know, he really respects Gintoki a lot more than he respects Jigata Toshiro, because he called Gintoki as Danna, which means boss, but he calls Hijigata, even though he was ranked higher than. His position is higher than Togo. He called Hijigata as Hijigata-san. Between the two of them, Togo respects more towards Gintoki than rather than Hijigata. Oh my god, that's a lot.
やったな。どうやら決着ついたようだぜ。どうだい？そろそろ俺たちも。ついてない。一度定めた標的を切るまでは鞘には収まらない。そうでしょ？人切りさん。
てめえは人斬りよりビル斬りの方が向いてそうだぜ。収まる鞘がねえなら、てめえにおあつらい向きなのを用意してやる。
そうかしこまるな。俺の標的はてめえじゃねえよ。悪いが、最後の一本は俺がいただいた。てめえみてえなでけえ歯には、そこがお似合いだぜ。鞘ん中で眠りやがれ、生倉。
Oh, the boss we just fight fought was her name is Imai Nobume. So I don't want to talk a lot about her because I think in the nations, the Curtain of Nations arc, we will get to play as her, I think, or in the side story, I don't know which one, but we will get to play her. So I will talk about her later. But just for one, point, she was one of my favorite characters. So, in terms of the female characters, as I've said in the earlier videos, previous videos, my number one character for the female will be Tsukuyo. So I think Imai Nobume will be the second one. I think that's it for this video. So I think it's it's rather short than the previous ones. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care. Assalamualaikum. It's been a pleasure.